So I thought I'd try something a bit different this week and do a bit of a conversation piece. So I brought in a new co-host, or in fact, the first co-host. Everyone, this is Alice. Alice, say hi.
Hi, everyone.
She'll learn quick.
Maybe. So
we're just having a quick discussion off camera about what to kind of call this segment. The thing is, we both have hot drinks.
Oh,
we both
yeah.
have hot drinks.
Oh, in time.
In time. We both have hot drinks. We thought we'd call this Brew and Pew. So this weekend just gone, myself, Alice, and our mate, who we shall call Lemon, went on a little road trip up to Newark to attend the Midlands Airsoft Fair, which has been running for a couple of years now, but I believe it was the first year for us going, and it's also, I believe, the first year they've held it at the Newark Showground. And we were in the cattle halls.
Yeah.
Because airsoft is a cattle. It's very true.
We're used to being outdoors, yes. In the rough.
In the rough. And being led out to slaughter. Oh. At least newbies are.
Yeah, to be fair.
So, what was your highlight of the airsoft fair?
Oh, I don't know. I did find what I wanted to find when I was there, so that was kind of a highlight. And then I think probably the chips.
The chips.
We got cheesy chips.
Can you tell she's a proper airsofter? The first thing she thinks of is food.
But the food stand was a bit small, and there were queues.
So what did you end up buying from the show?
So I went to try and look for a lighter rig, because at the moment I run a belt rig, and I've lost some weight recently. Yeah, so it doesn't fit anymore.
Just a quick disclaimer. Any weight she's lost, I've gained at least twice of
her. I managed to pick up a drop leg Molly square?
Panel,
yeah.
That's the one.
With a mag pouch on it. So this all came together. Came to £4. That's what I brought. I was really excited about that.
Did you not also buy a big box or something?
Oh, yeah, I spent a lot of money. So I brought some ammo from... So I bought a crate of blaster BBs, 0.25s, from some really nice store.
Was it Patrol? No.
No, I don't know what store it was, but they're really lovely. And they sold me 12 or 70 quid.
So I didn't actually buy that much. I bought some, what is it, fogs, anti-frog spray.
Yeah, and then some guy was just like, it's not real, man. It's not real.
Yeah.
That's
so
okay.
I'm going to give that a try and see if it works. If it doesn't, oh well, it was only a couple of quid. And then I bought this. No, not the MP5, not the scope. I bought the rail to mount the scope on the MP5. For Grand Crow Tour, £3. Pretty happy with that.
I think that's what these boot fairs are really good for, though, is picking up lots of little bits that you didn't realise you needed, or you really, really need and you can't buy in a shop because they'll charge you an arm and a leg for delivery.
Yeah. Or sometimes it's just, oh, I didn't realise I needed that, but now that I've seen that, it's quite a handy little thing to have.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, other than all the second-hand stores that are there, which I'm surprised, I thought there would be more of the second-hand stuff and less of the big shops, but it actually seemed a lot more like a lot of big shops and a couple of second-hand stores. So, I think the highlight for both of us and for Lemon would probably be GBLS DAS was there, giving off demos, so you could just go up and they're like, you want to have a shoot, and they give you a mag, they give you a gun, and you can just go dump it down range.
But they also would explain like the technicalities and how it worked, and there's a lot of people that were very interested in that.
Oh man, you know, I'm not an AR kind of guy. I think the closest gun I've got to an AR is probably an AK, but man, that DAS was nice. I would love to have something like that.
Also shiny.
It was it?
So shiny. It's really well made.
Really well made. And the stuff with the rails and stuff, I think it was genuine PTS furniture on it.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Not sure.
Yeah, because here's the downside to the DAS. They recommended retail price for it with stock and rail is £1,600. For the DAS. And I believe that comes with a couple of mags because they are proprietary mags. Think gas blowback M4 mags, but not gas, obviously. And I think it comes with a year's warranty. Did they say a year's warranty?
Yeah. Year warranty. I mean, yeah. I think that's good, but for the price you pay, I'd expect more in terms of warranty anyway, because they are the only makers, suppliers, whatever you call it for that.
Yeah, there are tech services for them now. They've got certified techs in the UK for fixing.
Which, again, is really good, but, I mean, £1,600, I really want to have someone that would be able to either fix my gun for free or replace the parts kind of for free. I wouldn't mind paying a little bit, but at least taking the service charge off or something.
Yeah.
Because that's a lot of money.
So, yeah, I mean, from a technical point of view, the DAS system is absolutely amazing. I mean, it's really pushing the boundaries of Airsoft in terms of new design, because really Airsoft has been quite stagnant in terms of technology. It's been quite stagnant since, well, the 90s, when the V2 gearbox came out that Tokyo Marui pioneered, and we haven't really changed much since then. I guess HPA has kind of come in. I thought it kind of went from HPA, went out of fashion, went to AG, and HPA started coming back again. But for those who don't want to be running around with a line and a tank, I think the DAS system could be really, really good, especially if it takes off and starts being adapted to other systems. Speaking of, I did ask them, I said, what's their plans? Are you planning to try and make any other models? And they said that very early stages they're talking about designing AKs with the same system, which I think would be pretty cool.
Anything to get you away from the AR platform?
Or anything to get me away from the AR platform. I mean, what I really want is SA-80 DAS, or even a SLR DAS.
That's way in the future.
So what was the other demo that was on, other than DAS?
Oh, so next to the DAS demo, there was a target demo, so some unique targeting system for Airsoft. I guess it could be used for paintball or...
But they said it could even be used for Nerf.
Or Nerf, yeah. Yeah.
So,
but it's so they're kind of like smart targets. So cool. Everything's smart nowadays, isn't it? So
Attack Sense, that was it. Attack Sense. They were really cool.
Yeah, they seem to be starting out. That was the impression I got.
Yeah, they're pretty new to the Airsoft market.
But it's very cool. So I did have a quick chat to them about their technical specs if anyone's interested.
Yeah. for reference, both of us are electronic engineers by trade.
Yeah. So that was really interesting, because it's something we've been thinking about for a while.
Yeah, I started making...
You always say you will and then you never have time.
I started making a prototype a couple of years ago. I got as far as making a sensor that knocked and it had a couple of LEDs that changed from green to red.
But credit to these guys. Yeah. They've done that, in a way.
Yeah.
A bit better. Sorry, Ben.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Mine was not a finished product.
And then they've got some quite complex software on top of that. So they've got an app. They've got competitive modes. So I guess explain what they are first. So they've got targets.
So yeah, so they're a metal back target, and in the centre of it is a protected light LED light box that they can change the colour of. The general idea is that the target has a sensor in it, can tell when it's been impacted, and then it can trigger in various different things. So all the targets, I think they said they can have up to like 50 targets?
32, I think it was.
Is it 32? Okay. So they can have a load of targets all hooked up to one controller, which is just a smart tablet or a phone running the app. And then they can set up various different scenarios. And the basic demo they were doing was a innocent threat system. So the targets would all flash yellow to show they're warming up, and then a target would either flash green or red, and if it was red you shoot it, and if it was green you didn't. And then it was all about who could get the quickest reaction time to hit them, or who got the best accuracy and stuff.
So it took into account how many targets you'd hit out the total, your quickest reaction speed and your average reaction speed, and that was all displayed for you on the app.
Yeah.
Which is really cool, because I think in Airsoft it can be a sport, it can be a hobby, however you choose to define it, but it can be quite hard to understand how good you are.
Yeah.
It's quite interesting to be able to compare yourself directly against another airsofter.
So I think this is quite cool. So
turns out I'm crap.
No, you were pretty good. You got a really good score. Like, you got the fastest score of the day until...
I was like third place until apparently the Masters of Airsoft came, Benjamin.
Apparently I got the fastest reaction time. It must have been a fluke, because my average was like a second between a target turning on and me hitting it. But my fastest time between it turning on and me hitting it was 200 milliseconds.
No, it was like 20.
20 milliseconds.
It was like 18 or 20 milliseconds.
No way in hell. That means I would have had to have fired before the target turned on for the BB to get down and hit it.
The speed of light. Competitive
mode, where two players play and the targets all start off blank, and you shoot a target, and if you hit it, it will change either green or red, and you play as either green player or red player. So for instance, say Alice was green and I was red, and I shot a target and it changed green, I'd then have to shoot it again to change it to red. And then the idea is it either runs for 30 seconds or until all the targets are one colour, and then if it's all the targets are one colour, that player wins, or at the end whoever's got the most colour wins. Also, the other thing that the attack sense targets could do is just have a simple I've been hit mode, which is quite cool, because you could pick one up if you've got a long enough garden, put it at the end and then use it as a helpful zeroing guide, and then you can definitely confirm whether or not you've hit your target that you're zeroing on, because it will flash yellow.
I'll definitely hit him. I can range 100 metres with my AGE that I got out the box. Sorry.
Yeah, but I think this could be a whole new avenue of Airsoft. So, I mean, you've got skirmishes, you've got milsims, battle sims.
But you have, like these sort of fake training things. See, I always think back to Call of Duty Modern Warfare.
Oh, you're thinking of the ship, aren't you?
No, the ship's the first level, the training level.
Yeah, the training ship.
It's not a ship.
It is a ship.
No, it's not. You're going to like this bunker thing.
Yeah.
On an airbase.
Yeah, but the layout is meant to be a ship. It's meant to be them training for the first mission of the game.
Not a ship, I always thought it was a desert.
That's Modern Warfare 2, the pit you're thinking of.
No, I've never played Modern Warfare 2.
You've never played? Oh, God, right. They mentioned to us that that's something that they're planning they can do. They can set up targets in multiple rooms and have them set up to do things like that. And have hostages and things, and they can have them change each time.
It would just be really fun, because... Yeah. For someone who's not that good at CQB, i.e. me, it'd be quite nice to know that I was going to walk into a room and I'd have to hit targets, but they wouldn't hit me back. That sounds really bad.
I know.
But I mean, I would probably train, quotes. I'd probably like to do it with a bit more confidence than I play CQB Airsoft, because CQB Airsoft is very much me, like, creeping around a wall, like, don't shoot me.
To be fair, though, your only real experience of CQB Airsoft is UCAP. And for those of you who don't know UCAP, UCAP stands for Up Close and Personal, and I don't think they have a semi-limit on any of their sites. Pretty much every site, no matter where it is, yeah, just go around that corner and spray and pray, mate. Because...
Yeah, but they still have to look down your sights, so...
Yeah. Well, it's obviously not like blind fire around a corner. But then again, their reasoning is, well, if this was a real situation and you knew there was an enemy around the corner, you'd go around full auto, wouldn't you?
So, speaking of feathering triggers and double tapping... when in a semi-auto only sight. That moves us on to the double penetration weapon that we saw.
Look at you taking over the hosting. Jeez. Anyway, yes. So first time for me, first time for her, and I think pretty much first time for everyone there, we saw the DT4 by Classic Army. For those of you who don't know, the DT4 is a double-barreled M4, and every time you pull the trigger, it will fire a BB out of each of the barrels. I guess it means... You know, it only takes one BB to kill.
Oh, yeah.
They say. And especially in CQB environments, if you're using that in CQB environments where you're like within 10 metres of someone, both those BBs are going to hit that person. And then if you spam that trigger.
They won't if they're me. Yeah. So
what I'm hoping. Well, I didn't see that the standard DT4 firing, but I'm hoping that because it's pulling two springs back, it's going to have a slower rate of fire. Which will mitigate that, especially in semi-auto, you'll have to wait longer to fire up your following shots. Cool idea, cool bit of tech inside as well. What I'm a bit concerned about is high-pressure airsoft were there, and they had brought along a DT4 that they had HPA tapped. And I didn't get any footage of it. I got some footage of it firing semi-auto. I didn't get any footage of it full auto. But, man, if you can... take that and turn it up to 35 rounds a second, 40 rounds a second that you can do with a HPA, and do that on both barrels. That's not going to be fun for whoever's on the other end of that. So, I like... Part of the reason I like playing airsoft is I like the kind of history of the guns and the the kind of knowledge around the guns. So when you walk up onto site and there's someone with an M4 that's shooting 40 rounds a second, it's kind of like, yeah, but you're just kind of breaking the illusion. Like, so some sites like to, well, some people say airsoft is all about the suspension of disbelief. And then you're kind of losing that when you've got someone with an M4 that would, you know, normally do like 3 rounds a second, really. 3, 4, 5 rounds a second. I think it's like 500 rounds a minute. But now it's doing 40 rounds a second. It's kind of like, you're not a minigun. You don't need that round a second. That being said, hey, if that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do.
And different ways you can play the sport.
Absolutely.
What's so good about airsoft?
There's so many different ways, like we've been talking about.
Speed.
Speed. What was that really weird gun you saw? The one that had the mag in the stock?
Quite a lot of those stocks about, actually.
Yeah.
Well, so there's a kind of new style of stock. It's an M4 stock, I think.
Yeah.
I think if I was going to go down the route of getting a... So I've got a AK that's sort of M4 style-y. It's got a...
Tactical AK.
Yeah, tactical AK, I think. In terms of if I was going to go down the route of customising that, I'd probably pick a stock with a spare mag holder.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't think you can get a spare mag AK holder.
Well, it's not really an AK, though. It's more of an M4 body AK mag in it.
It's not. It's an AK body with a railed front end and an M4 stock, sliding stock on the back. It's just kind of like a tacticalised AK, but it's kind of what the Russians are using now.
Yes.
Yes.
Modern.
Patches. There was that massive patch stand.
Patches!
So many patches.
I like them. Quite a lot. I think there was a couple of them. Obviously, there's always the standard offensive to women patches. Ugh.
Leave my tits alone with a photo of a cow.
Oh, but I don't think that's like... That's not offensive to women. It's more like...
Offensive to cows?
Yes. But, there's a standard offensive to women patches, obviously.
Mm.
And then there was some pretty cool ones. So, like... Oh, is it... You know, like a standard My Name Is... badge, and then it's like, I'm trying my hardest, and that's just sums up my airsoft in one sentence, really.
I enjoyed the, I'm not sure if he was selling anything, or he just brought his guns along so everyone could have a fondle of them, but he seemed to have every kind of...
No, he was selling.
Oh, man, but it was so cool, and he was really chill, and he let us all have a play with them.
Yeah, it was a really nice guy.
So, Aliens Pulse Rifle.
That was cool.
That's based off a Thompson gun. Obviously, Han Solo's blaster pistol.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful bit of kit based off the broom handle.
And then Stormtrooper.
Stormtrooper blaster.
That is heavy. E11. That was metal, wasn't it?
Yeah. So it's based off the... I think it's made by S&T. And it's a full metal Sterling underneath with all the bits added on top.
Minigun.
Yeah, it wasn't the minigun. It was the micro... It had the classic army micro gun. And he had the battery hooked up so everyone could stand there and spin it up. My favourite by far, Robocop pistol. Original Robocop, mind you, the only Robocop.
For those who don't know what Robocop is, it's a pistol and it's very long.
It's an M9, but it's got full auto. Unfortunately, Robocop had 3-round burst, but this one only does semi and full auto, but still.
It's very cool.
Don't move, creep.
I don't know what you're going to do with that, holster-wise, but make your own.
Well, I mean, if I was going to do it properly, the gun would be holstered inside my leg, because that's how Robocop's is holstered.
Oh, I've never seen...
You've never seen... We've got...
I don't know. So there was a new Robocop and there's a new Robocop.
No, there is only Robocop and maybe Robocop 2. Oh, one of the new things I've seen, I've never heard about this before. There's a new brand in town called Arthurian Airsoft, which are a UK-based company. They are making... And I know I said I'm not an AR guy, but I do like my classic rifles. They are making the M16 Vietnam style. So the original M16, the 3-prong flash hider, smooth body, no forward assist, proper, put it with a 20-round mag, but proper Parker. I quite like that. And as you can see from these videos, Lemon really liked it. And they also have an M203 variant as standard. And Arthurian brand themselves as, they're making mid-price guns, but they're trying to make them to as high quality as possible. So they're metal where they should be metal, polymer where they should be polymer. So the M16, it felt solid. Metal upper and lower, polymer stock, polymer triangular grips, and metal prong flash hide on it. I'm pretty happy with those, and might have to pick one up to complement my Vietnam kit.
No more, please.
That's not going to happen, hon. Newport were there, as always. Newport
are always good to have at these sort of events. Just have the classic gun walls.
Yeah, got the gun wall up. Got
always really nice guys to talk to.
They had G&G's most expensive gun, the MG42 there. That was...
Yeah, nice. They brought along a lot of G&G caps, patches, dead rags.
Yeah.
You got all the vultures descending on the caps at the very beginning of the day. It was fine.
I picked up the G&G catalogue, 2019 catalogue, and it was like this thick. Maybe. A5 sheet, this thick.
Made me carry it around for the rest of the day.
I got to ask the all-important question again. When is the G&G Lee Enfield dropping? And as always, the answer was... We don't know, but as soon as we know, it'll be on their Instagram. ASG were there? Their reps?
It was alright. I think there was a lot of things that weren't to my taste on that side. Well, I think so, like painted rifles.
Yeah.
But then again, I think those are people's personal kit, and can't really diss that, because it's your own personal preference what you run.
Yeah, they were pretty busy there as well. They always have people on the stand.
Oh yeah, yeah, it was busy. And there was always someone talking about one of the rifles, so that was nice.
I do have to say, I do quite like the CZ Bren that they've brought out. That's kind of like the Czech version of the SCAR. It's quite cool, quite modular system. Might have to get one of those at some point. That would be pretty close to having an M4, but not. And next to ASG, Airsoft Nation were there live streaming pretty much through the entire event.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Which is quite cool. I mean, we tried to get in the background of a couple of shots by like wandering in.
I think we are wandering in the out.
Huh?
I think we are in the background of one of them, maybe. I don't know.
But yeah, I haven't watched any of their live stream, but good on them for doing it. I think it's really good coverage as well, because you get to see just generally how busy it was. It was a really busy day.
Yeah.
I don't think there's any time where it was quiet. There was always people on stands.
Yeah. So coffee. Don't know.
There were lots of airsoft stands there, as you'd expect, and then there was just a tactical coffee stand. I mean, there was tactical coffee on more than one stand, but yeah, that's what that attracted me quite a lot. I do enjoy a little bit of coffee, and I think what was one of the names? Caffeinated Violence. That was it. I quite like that name. I think that's perfect for
tactical coffee.
Yeah, Tactical Coffee Company. But yeah, I thought it was quite unique, and I think, yeah, good on them. I mean, they've kind of picked the Airsoft as one of the Airsoft's great loves, is the free tea and coffee of a game day.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
This isn't free, but
I know,
still pretty cool.
Big Mr. Greenwood used to always like posting about having coffee on UCAC.
Who?
The big thing with Midlands Airsoft there is entry is £5, which is raising money for Pilgrim Bandits, which is all about... trying to improve the quality of life of amputee veterans. I think it's through giving them outdoor pursuits to do and activities to do, which is generally helping them.
For £5, you've got entry and an entry to the raffle.
Yeah, and you could buy more tickets throughout the day. And there were some pretty cool prizes. One of them was, I think the main prize was a TM M4 gas blowback rifle. Well, there's the MWS, those are really good. One of the pistol caliber rifles was also up. Oshi Boom Grenade, I think.
Yeah, there's a lot of rifles, grenades.
Gumbag.
Our
man Lemon won a gumbag.
Yeah. One of us won something.
By that logic, next airsoft-related raffle we go to, Alistair should win, because we did Pleasurewood Hills in November and I won big.
Big money.
Big money, I won a can of gas. So yeah, all in all, it was a pretty nice day. According to the weather forecast, it was going to be beautiful sunshine, nice and warm all over the country.
Well, this is the weekend where it was going to be like 20... Well, yeah, rumoured to be 29 degrees, but I think it was supposed to be about 23.
So, as you've seen in the footage, no doubt, we're both, you know, shorts, T-shirt.
Summer,
and as you shall see now, it is absolutely bucketing it down.
Yeah, I'm very glad I took a hoodie.
I'm just glad it was inside. If you were to summarise Airsoft Fair in one day... In one line?
In one day.
One sentence?
Friendly, good food, great interactive stalls. I think definitely worth a visit.
Yeah, I'd say that. A great way to help the sport grow.
And support charity at the same time.
It's
really important.
I think it's really nice that people who like to, you know, dress up and play soldier in the woods is at least helping the people who actually do it for real. Not definitely dress up and play soldier in the woods, but actually, you know,
sacrifice for us?
Sacrifice. Well, yeah, they've sacrificed limbs for us.
Yeah.
I think it's a really nice way to help raise money to look after them.
Yeah, definitely.
And, yeah.
A long may it continue.
A long may it continue. So anyway, I'd like to know your opinions on this kind of new style, new segment, the Brew and Pew.
Brew and Pew.
So, any thoughts and opinions?
Pew, pew.
If you are at Midlands Airsoft Fair and have anything you'd like to add, just drop them in the comments below.
Anything you'd like to contradict? Because obviously this is all our own opinions, you don't have to, it's not...
That
real life. It is real life, sorry. It's not law.
Anyway.
Or maybe it is.
There's been English Kiwi and TBC. See you around.
Lamb.